What we've been doing here are the first steps of what is called low fidelity prototyping. This is where we take paper to make simple representations of our designs. We create paper prototypes for communication and to demonstrate our ideas and to find out what works for a user. We don't want to invest too much into it. Sketching is cheap and engineering is expensive.
You said the word wireframes. Can you, I've heard that word a lot. Can you explain what that is?
Well, actually Clifton has a great example of a wireframe. A wireframe shows the basic information and placement of different elements. So he's got a little token here that kind of represents the image, you know, and I think that's become so familiar to us that we know that that's like a picture of somebody, even though it doesn't look like anybody I know. In fact, it looks kind of like a question mark with a little hump. And then this is text, it's placement for text. And he's put it within this frame, which is actually very similar to this frame, right, of our device. So, and then he's got some callouts and labels. So this essentially is wireframes, both all these wireframes, and the only difference, say, between his wireframes and yours is that he's constrained them by a frame.
Oh.
He sort of put that around, and he's thought a little bit about how things are positioned within this constraint. Mm-hmm. So he's already one step ahead, which is fine.
Wireframes show placement in an actual frame of a device, and flows are sequences of wireframes. Flows work to create a user interface story in much the same way as a comic strip tells a story. Now let's actually make some wireframes and flows using those conceptual models that we made earlier. In fact, let's bring all the elements you generated before, including the conceptual models, the discoverable signifiers, and the feedback, into our wireframes and storyboard.